We have now the Kurdish foreign minister with us for the Kurdistan Autonomous Region. We heard a little bit about that referendum that is being planned, but still no timetable. Thank you very much for joining us, sir. Can you tell us a little bit about how a referendum like this might take place and how quickly?
Well, thank you for hosting me. Indeed, today the president of Kurdistan was in the parliament in order to discuss the mechanism and also to set up the date for a referendum. Today we are facing a new reality in Iraq, a reality that has created a state next to us. We have a border which is 1,035 kilometers next to us, being the ISIS. So therefore that determines we have to think about our own future in the midst of all this turmoil.
I want to play a quick bite from you from Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. On Sunday, he came out in support of an independent Kurdistan. Here's what he had to say.
Regarding the Kurds, they are a fighting people. They have proved their political commitment, political moderation, and deserve political independence.
I just wanted to get your quick reaction to that statement. What did you think of what he said?
Well, this is the true definition of the history of the Kurdish people. We have suffered a lot. We have been betrayed. We have been divided against our will. We deserve a better future. Indeed, we have continued to play a positive role in bringing about a new Iraq, but that failed. It failed not because of us, because of the wrong policies in Baghdad. Therefore, we deserve a better future for the people of Kurdistan. Today, we are committed to a dual-track path that would be helping the political process in Iraq, because even if we go for independence, we still have to deal with Iraq as a neighbor. Therefore, the people of Kurdistan deserve a better future, and that could only come in through a referendum and to have an independence for the people of Kurdistan.
I want to ask you about what some analysts have been suggesting ever since we've seen this resurgence of violence across Iraq, saying that perhaps Iraq as we know it shouldn't exist anymore, that it should be split up into a Kurdistan north and perhaps even a Sunni Shia divisions in the rest of the country. When you hear things like that, even with your desire for independence in Kurdistan, what's your reaction?
Well, going back to history, Iraq is an artificial state. It was built on wrong foundation, a foundation that brought Sunnis, Shias, and Kurds together. We were annexed to Iraq in order to keep that balance. But any coercive union will not survive. This was the wrongs of the past have to be remedied today. We were independent in 2003. We went back voluntarily to build a better Iraq, and we were expecting that we would have a federal, democratic, pluralistic Iraq. But unfortunately, in the last 10 years, we have contributed positively to the success of this process, but Baghdad proved to be the wrong place because the culture is not there. The mentality of power sharing, wealth sharing, of democracy does not exist. We had the golden opportunity for Iraqis in 2003 after the removal of Saddam Hussein in order to build a better country. That was the case when we were talking about a federal state and when the idea of soft partitioning of three federal states within Iraq was proposed. We thought that that would be an opportunity for all the communities in Iraq to have it. And the fact is, Iraq is binational, multi-ethnic and multi-religious society. We Kurds have to have a better future because we want to have our own rights. But unfortunately, we were not treated as equal partners in the process. So today, the new reality requires a new policy. A policy that we have to secure our own people, we have to defend our own people and to secure a better future for them. We can't do that when we have 1,035 kilometers of border with ISIS and only 15 kilometers that we share with the rest of Iraq.
Okay. Thank you very much for giving us insights into that new reality and the new policies needed. Thank you very much. That is Kurdish Foreign Minister Falah Mustafa Bakir.